Hi there, what is going on? Today I'm going to address a question that was raised on my earlier video. Let's check it out. Below is the link for the video. May I know what kind of software I need to use for to make this one? So there's a link here. Let's check it out. That's very creative. I like it. I will show you how to create this type of video in 5 minutes. Let's do it. In the interest of time, I've already put in the video in track one and chop it up according to what I want. I've also inserted a song in track two and renamed it to song, as you can see here, and put it down here. If you're not sure how to do all these simple steps, please check out my earlier video. First step, I'm going to pull down the audio of the original video down to minus 60. Just pull the white line here all the way down, all the way down. So you will not hear any audio from the original video. Go to A here, which stands for text. Click it and then pull it somewhere across here. You see what happened immediately is that the system will generate a second video track. Rename this to lyrics. Okay, I've prepared the lyrics in the Word document, so I'll just copy and paste it here. Okay, and then use the control tool to adjust the position. Just put it down or put it left or right to adjust it. Next, I'm going to copy and paste it here, and then I go back to this track. I'm going to change the upper layer to blue. I'm going to change the lower layer to pink because that's how normally karaoke will color the lyrics. Alright? Then rename this to blue and pink. Going to insert another layer on top and rename this white, like this. I'll explain to you why I'm doing all this later. Select the white text, select the rectangle mask here, click on it, and then drag it on the top layer here. You notice that the system will automatically generate a mask here. Click on the invert button here and invert it. So what happened is that the mask apply on the higher layer, therefore it see through the white layer and look at the blue one below while maintaining the one below. Alright, so now open up the mask. You need to click this button here so that you can see what is happening here. I'm trying to create a keyframe. Okay, let's listen to the song. I want to listen to the end part. Okay, that's the last part of the male singing. I'm going to create a position here. Notice when I click that, there's a keyframe created. So a keyframe is basically a frame used to indicate the beginning or end of a change made to a parameter. For example here, a keyframe is set to indicate at which point the mask will come into play. So the mask come into play here. Alright, that's the end part. I'm going to listen to the beginning. Okay. The beginning is probably somewhere around here. I'm going to click on this text again, go to the selection tool, select mask again, and you can see the mask come up again. I'm going to move this to cover this word here. Right, that's when he started to sing the word. And then I'm going to go to the text, probably need to expand it a little bit earlier. Okay, alright, make sure you click the text again, click the mask again, you can see this, and then you can see the position again. Move this playhead to even before that and move it to somewhere here. Right? Let's see how it goes. Okay, that's a little bit fast. Okay, no happen here. Remove here. Listen to that again. Yep, perfect. Okay, I'm going to do the same mask for the female singing part. So in the interest of time, I'm going to do it very fast. I'm going to fast forward this part. One thing to note that is for the second mask, as you can see here, instead of add, I'm going to put subtract. Alright, you see the red color? Let's do the keyframing. Alright, there we go. So that's the end of the video, and I've already shared with you how to do the most difficult part. But if you choose to stay on, I'm going to share with you how to do the opening credit, and also share with you how to remove the vocal from any song so that you can create your own karaoke version out of any song. So please stay on. Next, I'm going to create a composite shot. Go to new, click on composite shot. I'm going to set the duration to 5 seconds. Click OK. Create a new text. Copy the one that I've prepared earlier. Ctrl V. Paste it. Select the text. Go to the text on the left hand side. Left aligned it. And then you can do a bit of beautification on the text. I'm going to do the one similar to the original video. Add shadow, white shadow, okay, and then do similar for the remaining text here. Black, and for the layer, for the shadow, I'm going to use yellow. Right, there you go. Now I'm going to put on a transition overlay. Just drag it here. I'm going to leave a link in the description below to share with you where to download this effect. Basically, it looks like this. Right? Now, obviously, I'm going to do something about it. So, let's click this blue eye here to hide it. And then go to the effects panel. Key in set matte. Apply this effect onto the text. And then under the text, under set matte, under the source layer, choose paint transition. That's how it looks. Next, I'm going to add another effect to the end of the opening credit. The effect looks like this. The steps are similar to the one that I've just shown you earlier, so I'm not going to go through the whole process of showing you how to do it. I'm going to fast forward this part. I'm going to leave a link in the description below so that you know where to download these effects. Alright, once this is done, go back to the editor timeline, go to the media and drag the composite shot that's just been created. Here. Put it in front. Right. Go to the control tool to adjust the position wherever you want. Somewhere here. Right click on this, go to the blend mode, select screen. Right, let's take a look. This is where the bonus tip comes. Alright, how to separate the vocal from any song so you only extract the background music. Go to this website, which is Music Kara. Here you can do everything online, you don't have to download any software. Choose upload audio file and then choose the file in your folder. I'm just going to demonstrate one of the songs that I use. This one here. Just press open it. Press submit. Okay, let's listen to what they have extracted. This is the original song. Okay, this is the one that they have been separated. Just the background music or just the instrument. beautiful, isn't it? Well, it's not perfect. Still got a little bit of, a very tiny, teeny bit of song at the background, but I consider this a very good, as a free online services.
And on top of that, they also extracted the vocal output. Let's listen to it.
Very good, right? So that's the bonus tip for you.
If you have come this far, thanks for watching. If you have any question, please feel free to ask me. I'll try to address it like what I just did. Anything relating to video making, video editing, I'll try my best to help you. Please like, subscribe, and hit the bell button so that you will not miss out any future content. I'll see you on my next video.